Thank you. In this short presentation, I will be discussing anime openings and endings and the genres of music they can be identified as. Anime music is not a genre of music in itself because there are numerous genres within it and the fact that they do not seem to follow separate rules. However, they often fit with the emotions conveyed throughout the anime, with the lyrics often relating to the protagonist. The songs I will be mentioning are Fire Vault of Philo and Borgen, the Attack on Titan opening for Season 1. This particular song is suspenseful, tense, aggressive, and could be considered somewhat patriotic for a country that does not exist. Next, History Maker, the Yuri on Ice opening. It is happy, creates a feeling of hope, and is overall inspirational. And finally, Unravel, from Tokyo Ghoul Season 1. It is melancholy, sings about feeling lost and alone, and generally makes one feel hopeless. Fire Vault of Pylon Borgen, also referred to as Guren no Yumiya or Crimson Bow and Arrow. The part of the song sung in the intro is completely in Japanese, other than the opening line, Shinshi das Essen, Nein, wir sind der Jäger. This can be roughly translated to, Are we the food? No, we are the hunters. This opening line encapsulates the feeling behind the first few episodes. However, when listening to the full version, there are a few lines in German, and while they are two very different languages, they work together in the song. The main character also seems to have German ancestors. His name is Eren Jaeger. The genre of this particular song is progressive metal. Progressive metal can be defined as a jazz-like progression of progressive rock that is combined with the aggression, volume, speed, and heaviness of metal. It is sung by Revo, a member of Linked Horizon. Next, History Maker. It is sung by Dean Fujioka, a Japanese actor, singer-songwriter, musician, model, and film director, with help from Taro Umebayashi and Taku Mitsushiba. History Maker is part of his album History in the Making. It is classified as the genre J-pop or Japanese pop. The melody is very steady, graceful, and calming. It is more like a waltz than a song normally used for an anime opening. The song is also sung completely in English. One such reason for this may be because it is the business or one of the most common languages, and therefore allows watchers from someplace other than Japan to connect with the lyrics on a more emotional level and to better understand them. It also fits well with Yuri on Ice because of the use of characters from all over the world. Yori Katsuki is from Japan, Victor and Yuri Plazetsky are from Russia, JJ is from Canada, Chris is from Switzerland, etc. And it makes sense that they would all know a few English words. J-pop can be considered Japanese language rock music inspired by Western bands and jazz in the 20th century. Music in this style can be traced back to the war era in Japan. More modern Japanese music is believed to have become popular in the Taisho period, 1912 to 1920. Western instruments such as the harmonica began to be used. It also uses the pentatonic scale. Finally, Unravel by Toru T.K. Kitajuma. He is part of the band Ling Toste Sigure. This song also falls into the category of J-pop. However, compared to the upbeat melody of History Maker, Unravel is somewhat depressing and is able to invoke certain emotions, especially sad ones. It fits well with the anime because of this. It sings of someone gradually slipping into insanity, portrayed by the somewhat breathy way of singing, and crossed between a growl scream near the middle of the song. Overall, there is a lot of contrast throughout the song as it shifts from being louder and more aggressive to quieter and more emotional. Say that again. Thank you for listening to my presentation.
this podcast, I will be giving a brief talk about jazz music, an American style of music which developed in the early decades of the 20th century, partially evolving from ragtime and blues music. Jazz has roots in the West African cultural and musical expression, and is also influenced by African American music traditions. It gained these roots when people in the USA, who descended from slaves imported from Africa, came to New Orleans. This is where jazz music originated. Jazz music is a wide-ranging style of music, characterized by complex harmonies, syncopated rhythms, polyrhythms, many swing and blues elements, and largely improvisation. Jazz can be played by many different types of instruments and many band sizes. A large band is made up of trumpets, trombones, saxophones, sometimes a vocalist, and a rhythm section. Although smaller bands, such as jazz trios, often contain a piano, a double bass, and drums to provide the rhythm. Jazz music is often known for a specific sound and style. Because the genre of jazz is so flexible and experimental, the instruments are too. However, the most common instruments featured in jazz music are the trumpet, the saxophone, which is the most well-known jazz instrument, the piano, the clarinet, the electric guitar, which is a newer addition to jazz, the trombone, the drums, which are used to maintain rhythm and movement in a jazz song, and the double bass, which has a strong and unique sound. Throughout jazz music, there are many different styles featured. From jazz fusion, a style from the late 1960s which mixes blues with rock and other styles, to Latin jazz, traditional jazz, a style originated from music played in the early 20th century in New Orleans, and bebop jazz, a style from the 1940s. This style featured fast tempo, complex harmonies, and a lot of improvisation. There is a huge variety in jazz music, but most jazz music is very rhythmic and uses bent or blues notes. You can often hear call and response patterns in jazz, where one instrument, voice, or part of a band answers another. The rhythm of jazz is largely made up of syncopated rhythms in the melody, which create complex rhythms. Other elements of jazz include the texture of jazz and the harmony. The texture is polyphonic, meaning two or more melodies playing together, but the lines of music move independently. The harmonies in jazz music are very complicated, using many minor chords and chord extensions. Many jazz musicians have their own distinct styles, so you may listen to the same song played by different jazz musicians, and each will sound different. This is because jazz is a style that mainly relies upon improvisation, so the song could be modified each time. The most famous jazz musicians include Miles Davis, Louis Armstrong, Duke Ellington, Ella Fitzgerald, John Coltrane, Bill Evans, Charlie Parker, and many, many more. Jazz is an extremely popular style of music, as it can express many different emotions, from pain to happiness. It's a unique blend of music styles, including gospel music, African music, blues, and brass band music. The musical notes which are bent or blues notes create emotion in the piece. To conclude this podcast, here are some interesting facts that I have learned about jazz music. The word jazz was originally US slang for excitement or energy. The piano trio is the most common jazz arrangement. Jazz music can boost your creativity and productivity at work. It can also relieve stress and increase your immunity. Apparently, if you listen to it for 30 minutes, it can also improve your immunoglobulin levels, which prevents viral and bacterial infections. Jazz introduced new dance forms such as the Charleston, Black Bottom, and Trot to the US. Thank you so much for listening. I hope you've learnt some more about jazz music. Thank you.
Charles Parker was an American jazz saxophonist and composer. He was a highly influential soloist in a form of jazz portrayed by fast tempos, virtuosic technique, and advanced harmonies. He was one of the most important figures in the development of jazz, and in particular bebop, which is what he created. He was also a genius who had no fear of contradiction that changed the course of jazz history. After his death in 1955, many other artists and fans studied his work, creating websites, stories, and many books on him. At the age of 34, Parker passed away from pneumonia and some undiscovered liver problems from drinking. He passed away in the end of 1955 as a famous award-winning soloist and saxophonist.
Thank you. evening. Today I will be discussing trance EDM. EDM stands for electronic dance music. So trance EDM basically means an electronically formed music that has a repetitive beat and synthesized backtrack. Trance refers to a state of being hypnotized. So trance EDM is an EDM genre that arose in the early to mid-1990s in England, Holland and Germany. It is distinguished by a tempo between 100 to 125 beats per second. Trance can also be influenced by other genres and music styles such as techno and house. Some famous trance EDM artists include Armin van Buuren, Tiesto, Skrillex, Paul van Dyk, Ali and Filler, W&W, Above and Beyond and Dash Berlin. In 2004, Tiesto, a trance DJ slash producer, who has now strayed from his trance roots into pop, was the first DJ to ever play in a stadium. Trance EDM is very similar to house music because they are both usually played in warehouses and large crowds. Trance is a genre that essentially evolved from house and techno to be more mesmerizing and memorable with repetitive beats and a faster speed that has a significantly less emphasis on extra percussion. Trance has repeating, thumping phases that can take listeners out of the world temporarily, as it is a genre to get lost in. This is mainly because of the dramatic build-up, euphoric drops and pounding bass lines. Thank you.
The blues, father of modern music. If it was your first time listening to the blues, you would notice the uncanny similarities between nowadays modern music, such as jazz and pop. Like many modern genres, they have been derived and inspired by the blues, which existed over 200 years ago. During the Windrush era, many blacks, originating from all the way to Africa to the Caribbean islands, had been taken to America as slaves. While many had to endure the suffering, many found a spark of hope. During the night times, families would sing as a source of comfort. Often the melodies were inspired by spiritual church hymns and the black culture that originated from their motherlands. However, it wasn't only for the night. During the work hours, as a bonded community, they would sing while working in the hot, endless hours. Passed down to generations, the blues made a significant impact in the books of history, inspiring many of what you see today. Can you remember any popular musicians who focused on the blues? Fun fact, the first published song of the blues was I've Got the Blues by Anthony Maggio in 1908. Here are some of the most popular musicians who primarily focused on the genre of the blues. On the left, you can see B.B. King. He was considered as the king of the blues, having sophisticated the world with his unique style of playing the bass and the electric guitar. His famous number one hit is 3 o'clock Blues. In the middle, you can see Jimi Hendrix. He was regarded as one of the most influential guitarists in the 20th century. At one point, he became the highest paid performer in the world. He is most notable for All Along the Watchtower and Hey Joe. On the right, you can see Bessie Smith. She was the most famous in the 20s and the 30s, nicknamed as Empress of Blues. She has sung with some of the most famous jazz musicians, such as Louis Armstrong. The musical elements. The blues have a distinctive style of playing. It's important to remember that all songs have 4 beats per bar, are built on the 12-bar blues form and use 3 4-bar phrases. Many blues songs feature a short instrumental break after each line, which is known as a form of a call and response. Some of the most popular instruments that are heard in the blues are brass instruments, which are often playing with the mutes, the saxophone, the acoustic and electric guitar, the Dixieland drum kit, and the double bass. A walking bass line, which is called a common harmonic device, in which the bass will play the notes of the chord and notes leading to the next chord. So what do you think of the blues? In my opinion, I think the blues are one of the greatest gifts that history has ever seen. And that even in the darkest times, there will always be a ray of hope. Music can be created anywhere. It just has to come from your heart. Something I would like to learn to play would be the saxophone, because it's always been one of the most interesting instruments for me, and also one of my favourite instruments. What is your favourite instrument? even though the blues aren't as popular as they were then. It's amazing to see that even today, you will find the elements of the blues played in many pop songs, jazz songs, and so many songs, even to rock and R&B, indie. So I'd like to say thank you to the blues. I'd also like to say thank you to you for listening to this podcast. I hope you have a nice day and that maybe you might have learned something from here. Thank you.
I'm going to sing Twilight by Aubrey Beswick. Street.